still some junior varsity matches going on.
Like, the whole time he was like, no. And like, later that night, he sent me a text of this girl that, like, complimented me. And I was like, did I not tell you?
And we've got, can't identify this Minneapolis wrestler in the junior varsity. He gets taken down by the Beloit wrestler.
Results of junior 85 minutes, about 42. Robbins of Minneapolis by fall over Kimmenaugh of Beloit.
Takedown points for the Beloit wrestler. So 2-0. And the pin. And we have another pin of Beloit over Coffee County wrestler over here. Smith of Minneapolis be in the junior varsity match. Coming up here on mat two.
Results, 285 pounds, about 42, Robbins, Minneapolis, by fall over Kimmenaugh of Beloit. Results, about 9, sweat of Beloit by fall over remainder of Minneapolis.
Gayer Smith of Minneapolis.
About 8, Meyer of Beloit by
against
fall
a Beloit, Republic County wrestler. And they get the takedown on Smith. Trying for the rollover. Gets it done. Going for the pin. And about got them out of bounds. They're out of bounds. Excuse me, this is a Russell opponent. And Smith is pinned here in the second period with 1:14 remaining. He was trailing 5-0.
Now up on mat two, about 12.
That should bring
Minneapolis Riley of Russell.
Nope.
Now on mat two.
Mat two, another Minneapolis versus Russell match. I didn't catch the name. My apologies.
Because of time reasons, the next round, about 43, will be delayed until 6 o'clock. So we will start the next round right away. 132 pounds. Next available mat, about 44. Pfeiffer, Russell, Republic County. Wait until 5:56.
Zero all with 1:20 left here in this junior varsity match.
Results about 11,
was Flax of Russell beating Smith in Minneapolis. This Minneapolis wrestler is in a problem here now. Fighting to keep from being pinned. Trying to roll through it. 3 points. Escape and back points for the Russell wrestler. It's 5-0. Period's about to expire the first period. Two more points, so that's going to make it 7-0. And the Russell wrestler is close to getting a pin here.
Results about 10. Guzman and Russell, Williams and Bloy. Results, Guzman by fall over Williams and Bloy.
Out of bounds they go. 41 seconds remaining. It's 12-0 in favor of this Russell wrestler. And the pin. Okay, we're going to have Cody Kind in the start of round three.
And cannot wrestle until 6:04, but about 47, wrestling with Beloit, Fillinger of Bobo.
Versus Chitty of Beloit. Dalton Chitty, a freshman, 4-7 record. Cody Kine came in with a 25-4 record as a senior. This is again 132 pounds, start of round three. Kine dives in, gets the takedowns up 2-0. Trying to get Chitty on his back and about has him there. Now does have him there and going for the pin and gets it. 1:18 remaining in the first period. Kind with the pin. The third win of the day for Cody Kind.
It's all there together. Russell now on. bat two. Next available, 132-pound, stop 46, long southeast corner by Ellsworth. On deck at 138.
And
just wait till 6:04.
I don't see another Minneapolis wrestler right now, so we'll be back after this word from our sponsors. We're in round three.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Linebackers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wall for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families.
Okay, after two rounds, Minneapolis is maintaining first place with 17.5 points. Russell and I think Republic County are tied with second at 12.5 points. So Minneapolis is maintaining this lead here in this first ever NCAA wrestling tournament. Okay, we're ready for the first action for TJ Ragnoni here today in the 145-pound class. Round three, TJ had buys in round one and two. A senior with a 21-2 record coming into today. He'll be wrestling Quinn Smith of Southeast Lane, a sophomore with an 8-13 record. TJ, one of the top ranked wrestlers in class 1-2-3A in this weight class. Ragnoni immediately goes to the dive and takes down Smith. Going for the pin. And makes short work of that with 1:46 left in the first. TJ Ragnoni with the pin. He will next wrestle Schroeder of Russell in round four. Next up from Minneapolis, see if I can look through here. Here in round three. Kyler Mick is in his third bye. He will wrestle in round four against Jackson of Beloit. Villapando of Minneapolis has a bye in round three and round four. And in the 220-pound, Donovan will wrestle Meyer Russell in round three here. Must have to have a delay. Robbins will have a bye in rounds three and four. We'll be back. Okay, Cooter of Minneapolis here in round three. See if I can get zeroed in here in the 152-pound class. wrestling Rodriguez of Southeast Saline. Is a soft freshman with a 20-4 record. Cooter came in with a 10-13 record as a sophomore. Cooter got a pin in his first match against Khan of Beloit and fell to a perfect Port Prester of Russell, who's 31-0 now, score of 11-7. Zero to zero, 19 seconds left in the first. Good tries to dive. Rodriguez backs away. Now Rodriguez tries to dive. And before the takedown, time expired. 0-0 after one. Cooter will go down, start the second period. Rodriguez in control here. Start the second period. Cooter trying for the escape reversal. A headpiece comes off, belonging to Cooter. They go out of bounds. And his headpiece comes flying again. You need to get a new strap for, I guess. And we have another delay. 0-0, 1:18 to go in the second. Cooter new headset, headpiece. Cooter will be down. 1:18 to go in the second. 0-0 versus Rodriguez of Southeast. Prester from Russell just won again over Beloit wrestler, going to 32-0.
Next available 170 pounders, about 53, Reed, Minneapolis, Windmills, Russell, on deck at 170, about 54, Holmes, Republic County, Burks, Beloit, and the whole 182, about 55.
Five seconds left here in the second. Rodriguez still maintaining control over Cooter. but still 0-0. Cooter gets an escape. So temporary blackout, not sure why. It's 1-0 Cooter, 3 seconds remaining. After two periods, Scott Cooter up 1-0 over Rodriguez of Southeast Slane. Start of the third period, Cooter on top. Now be up to Rodriguez to try to escape. Get an escape point. Cooter's got him in a headlock. Up. And a escape and reversal for Rodriguez puts him up 3-1. But they've scored a 2-1. So an escape for Cooter will tie it. .15 remaining in the third. Rodriguez in control and leading 2-1 over Cooter. Illegal hold. Time stops here. 56 seconds remaining in the third. Cooter down 2-1. Needs an escape to tie it. Reversal to put him ahead. And then he's like, 45 seconds. And Cooter is going to get him working on a reversal here. Oh, not quite. 7 seconds. And the time expires. Cooter will lose 2-1. Rodriguez, close match.
Now going back 270 pounds, about 53, to lead Minneapolis, Wendell Trussell on map two.
Excellent match.
Next available, 170 pounds, about 54, Holmes, Republic County, Brooks, Beloit.
Nick is still in a bye here in round three. .170 Reed here will wrestle Windholtz of Russell. Reed has 2 losses by pins so far.
Now above
down three versus wrestling Windholtz of Russell. Alex Windholtz. Windholtz, 13-2 in record coming in, junior. All right, we had a disc fill up, so I missed the first part of Donovan's match here, and we hit in time just to see him get pinned. He was against a 24-0 wrestler coming into the day, Alvarez. And Alvarez wins by a pin. First part of the match, Donovan gave a pretty good bout, but Alvarez is able to take control. So Donovan will wrestle Cadle of Beloit for round five. And that will do it for the varsity competition in round five. Logan Robbins has a bye. He will wrestle Cottonmire of Republic County. That ought to be a good one. Cottonmire is 29-1 as a junior. Logan Robbins 19-5 as a senior. We'll be back with some junior varsity wrestling in round five here, probably in a little bit. Okay, first junior varsity match of this fourth round for Minneapolis. And again, I apologize, I don't know the name of the young man. Russell wrestler goes in for the dive and gets a takedown for 2 points. And gets the turnover. Get in position for a pin. But he back rolls through it. There he goes. And is the pin. With 1:36 remaining in the first. Williamson of Minneapolis will be on mat two here in the junior varsity competition. Williamson's had 2 wins, I believe. No, this isn't Williamson. This is Daniels. Williamson will be next. Daniels dives in against the Beloit wrestler. Daniels dies, cannot get control of the legs. Daniels is taken down here. 2 points awarded to the Beloit wrestler. And he's pinned. With 20 seconds remaining in the first period. Keegan Williamson will be up here on mat two. Versus a Beloit wrestler. Keegan's had a couple nice wins here. In the last two rounds, he gets a takedown, up by two, and going for the pin. And he gets it. Congratulations to Keegan. Minneapolis, after four rounds, first place with 32.5 points. Okay, well, the final round will be starting here in just a few minutes. We'll be back.
The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency of Delphus, Minneapolis, and Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
For 100 years, a Schuler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schuler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards. And go Lions!
All right, final round to begin. Minneapolis leading with 32.5 points in this tournament. First off for the Lions will be Sam Plummer in the 160-pound class versus Romeo Zarate Russell. Sam came in with an 11-11 record, and Zarate came in with a 15-14 record. Plummer was pinned in the first round, has had three byes since then. So this is just his second action here. Wrestlers kind of feeling each other out, trying to get the right opening. Seconds remaining in the first period, 0-0. Zarate dives in on Plummer. Plummer fighting him off. First period's over, 0-0. Between Zarate and Plummer.
Yeah,
Plummer in control here at the start of the second. But no points yet for either wrestler. Enjoy watching Coach Chaz Hawk coach. He's like Coach Giles used to be. He really gets into it. Zero to zero, 53 seconds remaining in the second. Plummer still in control here. Sorate trying to get an escape. Plummer takes him down. Keeps him under control. Still zero all. Oh, just got an escape for Sorate. No points awarded yet, anyway. 15 seconds remaining in the period. They call the halt of the action. It's still 0-0. No points were awarded. Apparently, Zarate never broke the control of Plummer. There he gets a point. 1-0, Zarate. This period will come to a close with Zarate leading Plummer of Minneapolis 1-0. Plummer takes down. And tie with an escape. And we have a Minneapolis wrestler also on mat two. We'll get to that as soon as we can. Plummer still trying to escape, trailing 1-0. Constable of Minneapolis is on mat two. He's down to the Beloit wrestler right now. Plummer still trying to escape Zarate, who got one escape point, 1-0, 1:10 to go in the match. An escape could tie it for Plummer. Constable's down 2-0. And Constable just pinned by Emmett. Restart with 44 seconds remaining. Zarate still in control, 1-0 over Plummer. They both go out of bounds. 31 seconds remaining with this 1-0 score.
Next available bat, number 26 pounders, about 89, runners from Plummer County.
Plummer trying to escape. Tied the score. And Gesant gets an escape. No reversal, it's one all. 15 seconds remaining in the third period. Oh, reversal for Zarate right at the end. And he will win the match 3-1. right down to the wire. Those two, both freshmen, will be having some good matches for the next 3 years after this year. They'll probably have some matches yet in regionals, maybe state coming up. Okay, Hawk, Kristen Hawk, Minneapolis here in 126 pounds versus Rundus of Republic County. Benaiah Rundus. Rundus. That had an escape, but not quite. Hawk remains in control. Tristan Hawk had a pin in his first match against Smith, the Southeast Sling. 55 seconds remaining in the first round, first period. Working against Rundus of Republic County. Hawk has it by both legs and a put down. Takes a 2-0 lead. Now see if he can get it turned over and a pin. Escape, 1 point for Rundus here in the first period. So it's 2-1 Hawk. 54 seconds remaining.
Tyson Hall, third place, Ellsworth. In second place, Minneapolis, Sam Plummer. In first place, Romeo Zarate of Russell. Please report to the head table on the east end of the gym for your medals.
Sam Plummer got second place here today in the 106-pound class. You're getting a silver medal. Congratulations. Here we have 15 seconds left in this opening period. Tristan Hawk up 2-1. First period expired for Tristan Hawk up 2-1.
And first place, Blaine Harrison Blow. Please report to the announcer's table for your medals. Please report to the head table for your medals.
Hawk will go down to start the second period. I didn't hear the announcements of the 113-pound placers. I don't know if Minneapolis wrestler is placed there or not. Hawk trying for an escape here. Rundus hanging on tight. Start up again. 146 remaining in the second. Hawk in a bad hold here. Rundus trying to get him on his back shoulders. The referee started to count the hold three times now and stopped. 112, fourth time he's tried to go into it. Hawk gets turned over, out of danger for now. Rundus squarely on his back. Hawk four times. The referee started to count down the back, the pin, but four times Hawk got out of it. We had 3 points awarded to Rundus, and then Hawk gets a reversal. So it was 3-1, or 3-2, and now it's 4-3 in favor of Hawk. Now he's about got Rundus in a pin hold. 14 seconds remaining. 10 seconds. Two more points awarded to Hawk. It's 6-3 after two periods. Third and final period coming up. Tristan Hawk leading 6-3. Hawk in control.
Up on that one, 132 pounds, about 90, tied to Minneapolis, Bull over Republic County.
Got him in a headlock.
Up on that one, right after that, about 91.
Keeps him in control. Rundus is in a world of hurt here.
In the hole, about 94, 138, Butler, Southeast.
40 seconds left. Rundus up, or excuse me, Hawk up 6-3.
Results about 90, 132 pounds, kind of Minneapolis entry default over the whole Republic County. Results at 120 pounds, about 88, Turner of Southeast with a 5-0 decision.
20 seconds. Go out of bounds. Clock stops, 10 seconds remaining. Rundus will be down to start this last 10 seconds. Again, Hawk up 6-3. And he will win by a score of 6-3. Wins his second match of the day. Congratulations, Tristan. Results of the 113-pound class, Sean Cochran got third in that, so two medals in the first two rounds, a silver and a bronze. For Plummer and Conklin. We'll await the results of 120-pound and 126-pound. And the next wrestler up for Minneapolis will be Cody Kind against Trevor Lowell in the 132-pound class. Lowell comes in with a 25-4 record today, as did Cody Kind. Kind is 4-0 on the day. Back shortly. Okay, in second place in the 120-pound class, was Austin Constable. So Minneapolis now with two silver medals and a bronze in the bottom three weight classes. We'll hear the results of the 126-pound weight class shortly.
Next available man.
This is Wilton, not kind, in the 138. So kind will probably be on mat one. It's 4-1 in favor of the Beloit wrestler here, Wesley, over Wilton. Wesley is a senior, came in with a 21-3 record versus the freshman Wilton from Minneapolis. Tristan Hawk got first place in the 126-pound class. So a gold, two silvers, and a bronze so far for Minneapolis. Wesley is up in this 8-2 over Wilton. Make it 11-2 starting the second period. Wilton came into this contest 3-0 with one bye. Wilton trying to stay out of a pin situation here. Wesley has him in. 1:20 to go in the second. Wesley gets the pin over Wilton.
138 pounds, about 94, Challenger, Republic County, Butler Southeast on mat two.
Next so Wilton will go as a freshman, 3-1 with one win and a bye in the 138-pound class. Very good day. And he came up against a very good wrestler in West Carter Wesley, a 21-3 record. We'll catch the next wrestler from Minneapolis in just a moment. The 145-pound class, TJ Ragnoni, taking on Colson of Beloit, Zane Colson, a freshman with a 21-10 record. Ragnoni came into the day a senior with a 21-2 record, so it ought to be quite a match. 2 points scored for Ragnoni, I do believe.
At 132 pounds, medal winners. In third place, Trevor Lowell of Republic County. In second place, David Karolik of Ellsworth. And in first place, Cody Kind of Minneapolis. Please report to the head table.
Cody Kind, first place in the 132 pounds. TJ Ragnoni up 2-1 here. Apparently Miss Kine's last match. I don't know how it did. But. Forty-five seconds remaining in the first period here. Ragnoni up 2-1. Colson of Beloit. Ragnoni tried to dive. Colson had nothing to do with that. Seconds remaining in the first. Colson dives in on Ragnoni. Ragnoni in the spread to avoid it. Now the Ragnoni tried the same. And the first period expires with Ragnoni leading 2-1 over Colson. Colson will take down to start the second. Ragnoni maintains control. Won't let Colson escape.
In third place, Austin Butler of Southeast. In second place, Lane Wilton of Minneapolis. And in first place, Curtis Wesley of Beloit. Please report to the announcer to the head table for your medals. Please report to the head table for your
Wilton was second place. It's 2-2 now, an escape for Colson. 1:30 left in the second period.
Hop on mat 2, 152 pounds, about 97. Schneider, Ellsworth, Preston, Russell, hop on mat 2.
Two very good wrestlers here, Colson and Ragnoni. Ragnoni dives in, Colson spreads out. Ragnoni's got him in a leg lock, trying to take him down. Colson stays out of it.
Results about 96, 145-pounder Schroeder Russell by fall over Smith of Southeast.
35 seconds remaining in second period, 2-2 between Ragnoni and Colson.
Next available man, 152-pounders, Arcadia Southeast, Colin Beloit, on deck at 160, Nick of Minneapolis.
So say Ragnoni must have thought there was a break in the action. Colson didn't. 18 seconds remaining.
Wiggles, Russell, Schoen of Southeast.
Still at 2 apiece.
Results at 145, about 96, Schrader of Russell by fall over Smith of Southeast.
Colson goes for the late dive. Ragnoni holds him off. Second period expires 2-2. The score. Ragnoni and Colson. Ragnoni goes down to start the third. Try to get an escape point here. Maybe a reversal. The escape point is 1, so it's Ragnoni 3, Colson 2. One 30 to go. Ragnoni with 1 point lead. Colson fights off the dive attempt by Ragnoni. They get both each in a headlock. Colson gets him out of bounds. Ragnoni still up 3-2. 1:03 to go. Seven seconds remaining. 3-2 Ragnoni over Colson. Colson feigning for the dive. Ragnoni stretches out. 25 seconds remaining. Go out of bounds, 20 seconds remaining. Ragnoni, 3, Colson, 2. They're both up. Ragnoni holding him off so far. Colson goes for the dive. Ragnoni stretches out. 3, 2, 1, it's over. T.J. Ragnoni hangs on for the win, 3-2 over Colson.
Up on mat 1, 152 pounds, about 98. Brayden Connor, Beloit Rodriguez of Southeast up on mat 1.
Congratulations, T.J. Should win him first place in this weight class.
160 pounders, about 99. Suki of Russell, Mitt of Minneapolis. On deck at 170, Schoen of Southeast, Windholtz of Russell. And in the hole at 170, Burks of Beloit.
No one in the 152-pound class from Minneapolis. Cooter with a bye. So we'll be back for the 160-pound class with Mick. Okay, Matt won here. 160-pound in the fifth round. Kyler Mick up from Minneapolis. Versus Kelton Suchi of Russell. Russell came in. Suchi comes in with a 26-6 record tonight. Mick with a 27-1. Cucci a junior. Mick a senior. Mick had 3 byes and won his first with a pin. Which we didn't get to see. Both Suchi and Mick trying to feel each other out here. Mick for the dive. Still 0-0, 30 seconds to go on the first. Neither Mick or Suchi been able to get control of the other. Two strong wrestlers.
Next available, 170 pounds, Burks of Beloit, Gustin Wellsworth. On deck at 170.
Nick went for the dive. Sushi escapes. First period will expire 0-0. Sushi will go down to start the second. Sushi gets an escape, so it's 1-0 in his favor. So now Mick needs to get busy and go to work on a takedown. Trailing 1-0. Southeast. Please report to the head dance and pick up your medals. 58 seconds remaining in the second. Right. Sushi still up 30 seconds remaining. Sushi and Mick still trying to get the advantage over each other. Six seconds. And the second period expires. Sushi won. Mick won. Mick will go down to start the third, get a chance to get an escape and tie the score. Maybe a reversal and go ahead. Got the escape, I think. Nope. Sushi maintaining control here. Mick still can't get the escape here. 1:36 to go in the first. Still 1-0, Sushi of Russell. There's the escape for Mick, the tied score at one, could not get a leg hold to get a reversal. So 1:15 to go, it's 1-1. This match has the earmarks of an overtime. Something dramatic happens in the last minute. Mick goes for the dive. Can't get control. 45 seconds remaining. Had him down, but Sushi rolled over. 1-1, 40 seconds remaining. Nick tries to dive again. 23 seconds. Nick tried the dive. Suchi escaped. 5 seconds. Now Suchi to. Almost a takedown from Mick. The period expires. Goes to overtime. Tied at one apiece. One that scores a point wins. One to one. Nick goes for the dive. Suchi stretches out. And a takedown. Not quite. They go out of bounds. 8 seconds remaining in this overtime period.
Up on mat two.
1-1.
Justin of Ellsworth, Burks of Beloit on mat two. Next available mat, 100 to 3 Minneapolis of Belleville. On deck at 182,
and
Belleville.
Second overtime period.
And in the hole at 182, Dollison of Russell, Mosier of Beloit.
1-1, 30 seconds. In the OT.
Let's go, Blaine. Come on, Blaine. Here we go.
Put Sushi down. If he gets an escape, he wins. He does.
Results of 170 pounds.
Oh, he doesn't win. That's, they're going to go. He's up 2-1.
Blaine.
2 points for Mick on the takedown. They're going to go the full period. Suchi trying for an escape. 5 seconds. And Mick will win 3-2. Again, unless I don't understand the rules. Mick is up 3-2. To start a fifth overtime. Our third, fifth period.
Come on now.
3-2, Mick. All these gotta do is hold him off for another 20 seconds. And Mick is the champion, I would think. Fushi goes for the dive. Mick's trying to hold him off. 5 seconds. Suchi. 2-1-0. And congratulations, Kyler Mick. What a battle. 4-2, the final.
Next available man, 182 pounds.
What a battle between those two.
On deck at 182, Dollison.
Probably is not the first time they've wrestled this year. Probably won't be the last. So Kyler Mick should be the champion. Next up will be Reed in the 170-pound class against Holmes of Republic County. Holmes comes in at 6-12, a junior. Reed comes in at 1-6, a junior.
Nick of Minneapolis with a 4-2 decision over Suchi of Russell.
So Dominic Reed here in the 175 class, going for his first win of the day. Against Ashton Holmes of Russell. Holmes goes for the dive. Reed fights him off. Reed gets him in a headlock, but Holmes escapes. Now has Reed in control. Takedown points for Holmes.
Get out of that! Back out of that!
Up 2-0. They go out of bounds. Reed with the escape attempt. Holmes maintains control.
Medalist at 160 pounds. In third place from Beloit, Ryan Jackson. In second place from Russell, Suki. And in first place from Minneapolis, Kyler Mitt. Please report to the head table to pick up your medals.
Holmes has Reed down, right on the out-of-bounds line. Can't get him into a sufficient lock for a pin. Time expires in the first period. Second period will begin with Reed down.
Suck it off! Keep him on the mat! Keep him on the mat! Turn the mat!
It's 5-0 now. Holmes over Reed. That's the takedown points there. Probably reversal somewhere along the line. Reed's trying for an escape. And he does get a point for an escape. Makes it 5-1. Dives. Holmes stretches out and now has control. Two more points for Holmes, 7-1. Maintaining control over Reed. Got a Beloit wrestler doing well over here, leading 8-6 in the final period of their match. Holmes up 7-2, another escape for Reed. Second period expires. Holmes up 7-2. Reed goes down to start the third. And a point awarded for Reed, I think. Yes, 7-3. who stays down. Holmes maintains control over Reed. Reed has a reversal. Escaping the reversal makes it.
Come on, Blake!
They have put the score up. This is 7-3. Reed now in control. 1:15 to go in the third. An escape for Holmes. They are tabulating the score over here on the scoreboard. Seconds remaining. Thirty-eight seconds remaining. Bullet Wrestler just won a narrow one, 10-8. Made the crowd happy here. Dives. Holmes stretches out. 10 seconds remaining. Holmes gets control. And the period expires, the match expires. The winner, Holmes, 7-3 over Reed.
Up on that one.
182 pounds. Excuse me, Matt 2, Villopondo going for Minneapolis versus Reed of Republic County.
Results about 101 and 170 pounds. With an overtime victory, Blaine Burks of Beloit.
Reed, Harlan Reed came in with a 20-10 record. Villopondo came in with an 8-11 record as a freshman. Reed is a junior.
Results in 170 pounds. Ashton Holmes, Republic County, 10-3 decision over Dominic Reed, Minneapolis.
And Reed wins this one with a pin. 121 remaining in the first.
On deck at 195, Nichols, Russell, Paul of Beloit, and in the hole at 195, Cornick and Minneapolis, Murray out of Republic County.
Next one will be Cornick of Minneapolis versus Murray of Republic County. We'll be back for that. Okay, 195 pounds. Final match, freshman Chance Cornick against Blake Murray, freshman of Republic County. Murray came in with a 1-6 record, Cornick with a 4-13 record.
Results of 182 pounds, about 104, Jared Mosier, Beloit by fall.
Cornick won his first and lost the next three. Digging. There's a leg hold.
182 pound medalist in third place from Russell, Cody Billison. In second place from Beloit, Jared Mosier. And in first place from Republic County, Carlton Reed. Please report to the head team to pick up your medals.
Now, Murray is in control. It's two takedown points. Kornick gets an escape. It's 2-1. 40 seconds remaining in the first. Gets a takedown, 2 points. Takes a 3-2 lead.
Next available man, 220 pounders, Alvarez, Southeast, Kent, Republic County. On deck at 220, Donovan, Minneapolis, Peter, Lloyd. And in hole 205, Cotton Mara, Republic County, Robbins, Minneapolis.
First period, second period expires. Kornick up 3-2. Kornick chooses down to start the third. Leading 3-2.
Let's go, you Brady.
Excuse me, second period. Kornick trying for an escape. And he gets it. Up 4-2. Tried to go for a trip. Kornick saw it, kept it from happening. Stop. 50 seconds left. In the second period, Kornick up 4-2.
Got one away, extent of Republic County, Alvarez of Southeast. Now up on mat two.
Still 4-2, 25 seconds remaining in the second. Kornick with the lead. Holding Holmes off, or Murray off, excuse me. Second period expires, still 4-2, Kornick. Murray starts the third period, down, and down in points, 4-2. Kornick maintaining control here. .125 remaining, still 4-2, Kornick. Fifty seconds remaining, 4-2, Kornick. get a chuckle out of watching Coach Hawk. He's into it, folks. 47 seconds remaining. Cornick maintaining control, leading 4-2. Donovan will wrestle in the 225 class, starting her very quickly. 20 seconds remaining here, 4-2, Cornick. Donovan's gonna be wrestling a Beloit wrestler. 5 seconds, Cornick is gonna win this, 4-2. He'll go 2-3 on the day. Congratulations, Chance. Two and three record for the day. Won the first and the last. Okay, we're gonna have two matches going at once. Chase Donovan on mat two against Cadle of Beloit, and Robbins in match one against Cottonmire of Republic County. So I'm going to go back and forth as best I can. Cadle is 4-6 coming in. Donovan's 8-11. Cottonmire is 29-1. Robbins 19-5. Cottonmire Jr. to Robbins, a senior. We saw Cottonmire dominate us in football in the opening game of the season. I can see why, watching him here. He's a big boy. Robbins and Cottonmire feeling each other out. Looks like Donovan has control here, 2-0 in his. Cottonmire still kind of feeling each other out. Donovan still in control over here, up 2-0 with 40 seconds remaining in his opening period. 5 left and this one over here, 0-0. Cottonmire and Robbins, 285 pounds. Donovan in the 220 pounds. Donovan against Cadle of Beloit. Period expires. Donovan up 3-0. Robbins and Cottonmire go out of bounds. Still, Cottonmire's up 2-0. I didn't see that happen. Donovan starts the period over here down, leading 6-0. Well, I take that back. It's the Beloit wrestler up. Well, no. Mistook the colors of the ankle bracelets. It is Donovan 6-0. And that's at 1-0 over here now on the scoreboard. Pottenmeyer up over Don Robbins. Robbins goes down right at the end of the period. Pottenmeyer is up 3-0. Donovan goes down, Stark the second, leading 7-0. Pottenmeyer gets a reversal on Robbins, leading 5-0. Robbins rolls through it. Donovan and Cadel over here. Pottenmeyer maintaining control on Robbins. Now he's got him looking for the pin. Donovan just got two more points. He's up 10-0. Pottenmeyer going for the pin here on Robbins. Donovan going for the pin on Cadel. Pottenmeyer got the pin on Robbins. Donovan still going for his pin.
Next available.
And Donovan wins it.
21, Smith, Minneapolis, Riley, Russell.
Congratulations, Donovan.
That would be now up on mat number two.
Donovan goes.
Riley, Russell, Smith of Minneapolis now on mat two.
3-1.
Results of 285, Michael Pottenmeyer, Republic County, by fall over Logan Robbins of Minneapolis.
Well, here are the final placements of the
next available
final weights.
Track,
Smith in a junior varsity rat match
on
here.
On deck, about 23, Caden Williams of Minneapolis, Dustin Williams, Beloit.
We need the 182, the 195. 220, so we got four classes to hear results on. Donovan, second place in the 220. Smith here working on in the junior varsity contest. Have you announced 195 yet? Cornick third, Nichols second. Okay, Nichols third, Mark second. That's three, okay. Sure, thank you.
Come on, give it all, let's go!
Smith's match is over, I guess.
Now, about mat two, about 22, Major Minneapolis flag. Russell now up on mat two.
Leader of Minneapolis on mat two.
Next available, about 43, Williams of Minneapolis, Williams of Beloit.
And the Russell winner takes this one.
Now up on mat two, Dustin Williams of Beloit, Keegan Williamson.
Williamson of Minneapolis versus Williams of Beloit. Williamson, Minneapolis, Williams, Beloit. Junior varsity contest. Almost tumble over the cheerleaders. Williamson, Minneapolis, Williams, Beloit here in the junior varsity. Seconds left in its opening round. It's 0-0. Out of bounds. 35 seconds remaining in the first. So zero all, 15 seconds remaining in the first period. Two points given to Williamson there at the end. He's up 2-0. Second period begins. Williamson goes down. Got Williams in control. Got him in an arm bar here. A friend?
Coaches,
And we get a pin by Williamson. Though you couldn't see it due to uncooperative people in front of me. My apologies. All right. I think we're going to get a second place for Robbins here in the heavyweight class. We'll get the announcements of the team scores.
Results about 111-285. Garrett Kavanaugh, Beloit, an 8-3 decision over Chase Wheeler of Ellsworth.
We'll be back with the team scores. Okay, final team scores here. Minneapolis first with 161 points and the NCAA title. League title for the 2015-16 school year. Beloit second, 147.5 points. Southeast third, Russell fourth. Republic County fifth and Ellsworth sixth. Outstanding wrestler goes to Westling and Beloit. Robbins from Minneapolis finished second in the 285-pound class. Donovan finished second in the 220. Kornick finished fourth in the 195. Villopondo fourth in the 182. No finishers in the 170. Mick first in the 160. No finishers in the 152. Ragnoni first in the 145. Wilton second in the 138. Cody Kynes first in the 132. Hawk first in the 126. Constable second in the 120. Conklin third in the 113. And Plummer second in the 106. Dale Leach going to sign off. Regal Communications, congratulations to the champions of the NCAA League Wrestling here in Beloit on September 4th, 2016. Congratulations, Coach Hawk, Johnson, Mick, and Darcy. There are your champions. Getting their picture taken here. As well they should. See if I can get some of these other picture takers out of the way so I can get a decent shot. But I won't. Hope you've enjoyed these broadcasts on here on Eagle Communications Channel 20, SlinerPost.com, and Minneapolis Video Channel/via YouTube. Dale Leach going to sign off.